shall be discussing the topics related to nuclear forces. Firstly, we shall be talking about the nuclear stability. Then we shall talk about nuclear forces and what are the various properties of nuclear forces. As you all know that packing fraction is a factor which determines the stability of the nucleus. If the packing fraction value is less or negative, this means that nucleus is stable. But if the packing fraction value is positive or more, we say that the nucleus is unstable. And every nucleus has a tendency to move towards the region of stability. So it disintegrates, it either goes fission reaction or it undergoes fusion reaction to attain stability. So it has been found with various experiments that those nuclei in which the number of protons are even or the number of neutrons are even, that nuclei are stable. So there are 165 stable nuclei for even proton and neutron number. But if the protons are even and neutrons are odd, or if the number of protons are odd and the neutrons are even, the values are quite equal to each other and the stable nuclei are found to be 57 and 53 respectively. For the odd or combination where the number of protons and number of neutrons are both odd in a particular nuclei, there are only 6 stable nuclei. So for the stable nuclei, generally those nuclei are stable which have even number of protons and even number of neutrons. And the total stable nuclei that are there, that are 281 out of 900 nuclei found. So if we see the stability curve, in which on the y-axis we have the number of neutrons, on the x-axis we have the number of protons. So we see that if we draw a n equal to z line, where n equal to z line means that number of proton is always equal to number of neutrons. But we see that the stability curve is not lying on the straight line that is inclined an angle of 45 degree with respect to x-axis. The stability curve is shifting towards the number of neutrons. Why is this so? Because if in a nucleus the number of protons starts increasing, what will be there? Since the proton is positively charged, it will give repulsions. There would be Coulombic repulsions between the nucleus, and that would cause instability in the nucleus. So for stable nuclei, the number of neutrons are more in comparison to the number of protons. If we see the second graph, where this is also a graph between the number of neutrons and protons, we see a particular region of stability. So what does this region of stability means? That those nuclei which are not in this region, those nuclei who are on either left hand side of the stability region or on the right hand side of the stability region, they always try to fall in this region of stability so that the nucleus would be stable. They undergo either fission reaction or fusion reaction by emitting alpha particle or by emitting beta particle, gamma rays, so that they could attain the region of stability. So this is one of the reason why there is a region of stability, because the number of protons would not contribute to the Coulombic repulsion. But if the proton number is there more, then the Coulombic repulsions would be more and their nucleus would be unstable. So that is why the region of stability or the stability curve is shifting towards the neutron side. So next topic that we are going to cover is the nuclear forces. So nuclear forces, what is nuclear forces? We know that there is some certain force which is responsible for the stability of the nucleus. If only there was gravitational force or Coulombic forces present, then the nucleus would have not been stable, because there are some protons which are positively charged. So positively charged would produce repulsions, and since neutron is not having any charge, so there would be no interaction between a proton and a neutron. So how could a proton neutron or a proton proton live inside the nucleus, or a neutron neutron could live inside the nucleus? So there must be some force which is binding proton proton, neutron neutron, proton neutron, which are exactly different. So there were some particles suggested. There was a Japanese scientist Yukawa which gave the Yukawa theory or the meson theory. He said that if there is a gravitational force present in nature, there is an exchange of particle between the gravitational forces. That gravitational
forces were exchanged by the particle which were called as gravitons. Similarly, there must be some exchange particle between the protons or neutrons which are holding the proton neutrons together. So these particles were called as mesons. So what was there? What was the theory proposed by Yukawa? He said that protons and neutrons are considered to be a particle which is not carrying any charge. That is why we have represented positive, negative. It is electrically neutral particle. So neutron is also neutral, proton is also neutral. But here it has been surrounded by a cloud of mesons. So these mesons are continuously exchanging between the proton and neutrons. Why these proton and neutron is being attracted, or they are being bound to each other. So the meson cloud is the most responsible factor which is binding the two neutrons, two protons and two one proton and one neutron in the nucleus, and it is giving stability. It was found that the forces due to the mesons were called as the strong forces or the Yukawa forces, and these strong forces were the strongest in nature. The Yukawa forces was found to be 100 times stronger than the Coulomb's repulsive forces, and it was 10 raised to power 38 times stronger than the gravitational forces. And that is the reason why the Yukawa forces or the nuclear forces are the strongest in nature, and they are binding the two protons, two neutrons and one proton, one neutron inside the nucleus. Without these mesons, it is not possible to keep the protons and neutrons inside the nucleus. So the mesons came into existence, and the exchange of particle between the neutron and proton was meson. So what did the meson theory suggest? It predicted that all nuclei consist of identical cores surrounded by a cloud of one or more mesons. Second, these mesons could be neutral, that is pi naught, or it could be electrically charged. It could be positively charged or negatively charged. So the pi mesons were represented as pi naught, pi positive and pi negative. Difference in the proton and neutron was there in the composition of the respective meson cloud. See here, this is a neutron, this is a neutron core, this is a proton core. So here, what is the difference in the meson cloud? Since it is a neutral particle, so here there must be a pi zero cloud of mesons, and for proton here it must be a cloud of pi positive. If supposingly this pi positive shifts here and this pi zero mesons shift here, so then what will happen? Then the proton would be changed into neutron, and if pi positive shifts here, then this would be becoming as proton. So the exchange of mesons were determining whether it is a neutron or a proton, and proton-proton binding is there, neutron-neutron binding is there. So the forces that act between neutron-neutron or between proton-proton are due to the exchange of pi naught, neutral pi mesons. Whereas between a proton and a neutron, the exchange could be due to the charged pi mesons, which could be pi positive or pi negative. So here are some equations: that the neutron becomes proton when the proton is surrounded by pi negative. But we can say that the proton can be changed into neutron if neutron is get surrounded by pi positive mesons. Similarly, if proton is changed to another proton, where this p dash and p means that the protons are in different states. It is in one excited state, here the p dash is in the other excited state. So these two protons must be differing from each other by a meson cloud of pi neutral. Similarly, a neutron and a neutron in another excited state could be differing from each other by surrounding envelope of neutral pi meson. Similarly, if p is surrounded by, proton is surrounded by a pi negative meson, then it would result into a neutron. Similarly, if neutron is surrounded by a pi positive meson cloud, then it would result into a proton. Similarly, if proton is surrounded by a pi neutral, it would give a proton in a higher excited state. Similarly, a neutron if surrounded by pi naught would give a result into a neutron into a different excited state. So this was the predictions about the Yukawa theory given by Yukawa, Japanese scientist. And there are some other properties of the nuclear forces. So let's study what are the various properties of nuclear forces. So as we know that the nuclear forces were the strongest forces. So the first property that came into existence was that the Yukawa forces or the nuclear forces were short range forces. Short range, why they were short range? Because the nucleons existed inside the nucleus. These forces had to be applied within the nuclear range. So it was found that the nuclear forces were only effective if the distance between the nucleons were in comparison to the size of the nucleons. If the distance between the nucleons is comparable to the size of the nucleon, then only the nuclear forces were operative. So the distance between which the nuclear forces were affected, that distance was called as the range, and the range value was found out to be 2.2 Fermi. So they plotted a graph between the various forces, either it could be the repulsive force or it could be the attractive force, and the distance between the nucleons. So what does this graph represent? It represents that if we are bringing two nucleons close to each other, here the two nucleons are separated by a distance of 4.2 Fermi. So at this 4.2 Fermi distance, there is no attraction, no repulsion felt by the nucleons. But as we move it closer, as the nucleons are brought closer to each other, they start experiencing an attractive force. So as you go on decreasing the distance between the nucleons, the attractive force goes on increasing. But at the distance of 1.5 Fermi, the attractive force is maximum. They experience maximum attractive force. Beyond this distance, if we further decrease the distance of the nucleons beyond 1.5 FM, what happens that the attractive force starts decreasing because the Coulombic repulsions might be exceeding the attractive force. So the attraction becomes less, and when the distance between the nucleons reaches 0.5 Fermi, there the nucleons experience no attraction, no repulsion. This is a zero number line. So at this 0.5 Fermi distance, the nucleons experience no attraction and no repulsion. And if we try to further decrease the distance beyond 0.5 Fermi, the nucleons suffer heavy repulsions. They suffer heavy repulsions and they are forced to move apart. So from this graph, it is clear that the nucleons had to be separated from with a certain distance, and that distance was called as the range, which was measured to be found to be 2.2 Fermi. The second property, what was there? The second property was charge independent, that the nuclear forces were not depending upon the charge of the nucleon. Either the proton is carrying a positive charge or neutron is not carrying any charge. Since there the nuclear forces were operating on these nucleons and they were holding the nucleons tightly. So what they confirmed, the charge independence was confirmed by analyzing the difference in the binding energy between the mirror nuclei. So what do you mean by mirror nuclei? Mirror nuclei are the nuclei in which the number of proton in one isotope or one element is equal to number of neutrons in the other nuclei or other element. Similarly, the number of neutrons of the first element should be equal to the number of protons of the second element or isotope. So they compared the binding energy. So they found that the binding energy of the tritium was found to be 8.49 mega electron volt, and the binding energy of 2He3 helium was found to be 7.72 mega electron volt. So why they are mirror nuclei? Because in tritium there is one proton, and in helium how many neutrons are there? That is 3 minus 2, that is 1 neutron. Similarly, in tritium number of neutrons is 2, that is 3 minus 1, and here in helium number of protons is 2. So they both are mirror nuclei. So they found that there is a difference in the binding energy, although the number of nucleons is 3. There are 3 nucleons total. So the total nucleons in both the tritium and the helium isotope are 3. But they found that there was a difference in the binding energy of the factor of 0.77 mega electron volt. Why this factor arised? Because in helium there were two protons, whereas in tritium there was only one proton. So in the helium where there were two protons, there would be some binding energy lost in the Coulombic repulsions of the two protons. So these factors contributed that there exist charges. So that proved that there are charges in the nucleons and the nuclear forces is independent of the charges. Third is that they are spin dependent. Spin dependent means that the protons and neutrons both have spins. So what is there? It was found that the nuclear forces for the nucleons which are having same spin, either they are having up spin or both are having down spin. In that case, the nuclear forces were found to be greater than the nuclear forces for the nucleons which were having antiparallel spins. That is, one nucleon is having up spin and another nucleon is having down spin. So it was found that the nuclear force for the parallel spin is much greater than the nuclear force for the antiparallel spin. So the nuclear forces depended upon the spin factor. Fourth point is that the forces were non-central. Non-central, what are central forces? Central forces means that the force is acting along the line joining the center of the two particles between which the force is acting. So here these strong forces or the Yukawa forces were not acting along the line joining the two nucleons. It may be more regarded as they were called as the partial non-central forces. So the fifth property was that they exhibited the exchange character. Already we know that the protons and neutrons or the two or any nucleon is held together inside the nucleus by the exchange of the mesons, that is the exchange of the mesons. So the nuclear forces exhibited the exchange character due to the meson particles. Sixth property is that the saturated forces. Saturated forces means that the nuclear forces were not supposed to be indefinite. They were not that the nuclear forces could be acting on any number of nucleons. Means a one nucleon is interacting with any number of nucleons and nuclear forces are there. It was limited. It was a limited force. The only nucleon, if there is one nucleon in the center and there are some nucleons surrounding the center nucleon, so the nuclear forces would be effective for a surrounding nucleus. Not means that it would be the nuclear force would be there for any nucleon at any distance. So if there was a saturation forces in the nuclear forces, so this means we can prove this as if there are a nucleons present in the nucleus. So the first nucleon will interact with left out nucleons. How many nucleons are left? That is a minus one nucleons are left. So it does not mean that a nucleon will react with a minus one. So if we want that, so saturated forces means that a nucleons would not react, would not have force with all the a minus one nucleons. This was proved here. Supposingly, we suppose that every nucleon is reacting with every other nucleon. So a nucleon is interacts with a minus one nucleon. So the binding energy would be proportional to the pair of the nucleons taken at a time. So we will have a combination of AC2. AC2 means we take a combination of A nucleons taking 2 at a time. So we get that this is equal to A into A minus 1 upon 2. So A into A minus 1 upon 2 means it is equal to A square minus A upon 2. Since A square factor is greater than A, so we say that binding energy here is proportional to A square. But it was found that the binding energy is not proportional to A square. It is only proportional to A. It is not proportional to A square. It is only proportional to A factor. So this means that the forces of the nuclear forces were saturated. They were limited to a number of nucleons. The last and the most important property of the nuclear forces were that these were the strongest forces that exist in nature. It was found that the nuclear forces is 100 times stronger than the electrostatic repulsion Coulombic forces. So we know if Coulombic repulsions were the major factor were the major force. It would, if they were stronger, then the two protons could not resist inside or live inside the nucleus. But since they are stronger 100 times, that is why the two protons are getting binded in the nucleus. And also it was found that the nuclear force is 10 raised to power 38 times stronger than the gravitational attractive force, which means that the electrostatic force is 10 raised to power 36 times stronger than the gravitational force. And it conclude, we conclude that the nuclear force is the strongest, and it is 10 raised to power 38 times stronger than the gravitational force, or 100 times stronger than the electrostatic Coulombic repulsive forces. So these are the various properties of the nuclear forces, which shows that the nuclear forces are the strongest and they are the most important factor that holds the nucleons together inside the nucleus. So I hope you must have understood this concept. Thank you.